Hello, I am Dr. Rajshekar Mysore from Chirag Hospital, JP Nagar, Bangalore. I am a practicing general surgeon and colorectal surgeon and a proctologist for the past 40 years. My intention of doing these videos is to simplify the confusions in the minds of the people, and I'll use as little as possible the technical terms and make people's understanding of the disease more simpler. Tips for management of post-operative hemorrhoidal surgeries. So there are two aspects of post-operative management in hemorrhoidal surgery. One is post-operative bleeding, second one is post-operative pain. Post-operative bleeding to be taken care during the surgery, but some of them we call it as a reactionary hemorrhage or secondary hemorrhage at a later stage when the sutures become loose or when the wound gets expanded, one can get bleeding. So post-operative bleeding has to be addressed to at the earliest whenever there is hemorrhoids, surgery for hemorrhoids. There are two ways of looking at post-operative care of hemorrhoids. One is the surgeries we choose. See, hemorrhoidectomy, where you remove the hemorrhoidal masses, big wounds will be there, or even if you close it, there will be closed wounds. It will be causing lot of pain post-operatively. Sitting will be difficult. While passing stools, it will be really painful and all that. So nowadays, we don't do hemorrhoidectomy. In our practice, we don't do hemorrhoidectomy, except for external hemorrhoids, which are there outside, we may use lasers to remove those things. Otherwise, classical hemorrhoidectomy, removing the both external and internal components, will be really painful and associated with a lot of post-operative complications also. So if that can be avoided using other methods like Doppler-guided hemorrhoidal artery ligation, infrared coagulation, laser hemorrhoidoplasty, there are so many other new advancements are there, which has made our life simple. So it is extremely rarely we see that post-operatively patients will be really suffering from pain using this tubes and all to sit. In our practice, it is very, very rare to see that sort of pain. And patients will be able to have their normal, regular, normal food and able to pass motion very next day. Of course, pain is a very subjective symptom. So those who have got lot of pain and those who can't tolerate, their pain tolerance is very low. For them, you have to use more powerful painkillers and all. But lot of issues with diet and all are not required. They can have regular normal food, avoid very spicy food, and avoid dry type of food which can cause constipation. Apart from that, there are no special diets or special precautions to be taken post-operatively for hemorrhoidal surgeries if they are done in a proper manner. Post-hemorrhoidectomy, if it is done, where it is removed, of course, very soft diet they have to take, and they may have to take stool softeners, and many other precautions are to be taken if hemorrhoidectomy is done.